I want to talk today about a very complicated topic. So I'm only going to touch on it briefly because there's a lot I could say about it. This is the topic of perfectionism for people with rainforest minds, because it's not it's just there are many pieces to it. It's not as simple as maybe people make it out to be. So if you're grappling with it, just know that there's a lot going on with it, with the issues around it. And it's just this one word, perfectionism, and it doesn't really quite describe some of these things. I had a client this week, and she was talking about some parts of it that I just want to mention to you briefly now. And I'll probably write about it in more depth on my blog, and there's a whole chapter on it in my book, in my first book. So there are resources for you to go to if what I'm presenting today is kind of frustrating because I don't tell you the whole story. But this particular client was talking about a couple of things. Oh, there was just a hummingbird outside my window. Anyway. Wow. Okay. So, she was talking about a couple of things that I identified right away as, this is a perfectionism issue. So one was a thing where things come easily to her. And when you have a rainforest mind, you often learn very quickly. Learning comes easily, especially with things that you're interested in. And so the challenge was she was trying something that wasn't easy. In her case, it was a new painting technique, and she wasn't successful at it right away, and so the feeling was that she just wanted to quit and not do it because obviously it wasn't a talent that she had or something. It didn't come naturally, and so we talked about how it's important to try things anyway, to do things that you don't necessarily do well right away. That's what you're used to because you have this reinforced mind. But in fact, it would be sad if you didn't try things and work at something and practice doing something difficult. And in fact, if you're a parent, that would be extra important because you want to model that for your kids, because even young children learn very quickly that they need to be smart at everything and really good at everything, and if they're not, they might not want to do it. Okay, so that's one part. This is so much to this. There's fear of failure is a big thing, fear of making mistakes that comes with this. And then another piece is that she was also talking about that she couldn't excel too much at the different things that she did because she got the message, don't think you're so smart. Don't be so full of yourself. And so she tended to also sort of like dumb down the things that actually she could do really well and not get too good at it because that wasn't working for her either. So ooh, there's so much to this and it's so complex. And the other quick thing I will tell you today is there's a whole other piece of what I'm calling perfectionism, which some people call healthy perfectionism. I call intrinsic perfectionism because in the rainforest-minded person, there is this deep drive for beauty, balance, harmony, precision, and justice. So think about that for a minute. Do you have that in you? Is there like this big need for perfection in those deep qualities? And that's something that is intrinsic to your nature, something that you want to learn to embrace, you want to appreciate about yourself. And sometimes maybe you have to prioritize different activities that you're doing so that you get some things done. But that's another aspect of the complexity of what we're calling perfectionism. So I just wanted to mention those quick things to you today and know that you can follow up. I'll probably talk more about it, and I've written about it in those different places. So it's good to see you. Mwah. Sending you love.